A new function coming to CSS, calc-size, allows you to easily animate using CSS transitions to hide auto and other intrinsic sizing keywords. I introduced it recently, but the implementation changed a bit, so it works differently now. More importantly, there is a new accompanying CSS property that allows you to switch to this new proper transition behavior for an entire page easily. It's simpler and more elegant than calc-size, and I think you'll love it. Here's what you need to know. This is the demo that I've shown you earlier, where we essentially wrapped our auto value of height property into calc-size function, and immediately our transition starts working. This is no longer working in Chrome Canary, and the single argument form of calc-size, this one here, has been dropped since. What changed? I'll explain this in a bit, but first I want to mention that calc-size is supported in Chrome Stable 128 at the moment, and it is working in this single argument form. This will no longer work once you update your Chrome, and that's why I need to tell you what changed. Initially, the calc-size function allowed single attribute form and two attribute form, and I've shown you how to work with a single attribute form because essentially we wanted to allow browser to animate to hide auto and we didn't need to do any calculations. So I didn't even show you how two argument form works in the previous video. The two argument form of calc-size works in a way that first argument is intrinsic sizing keyword like value auto that we have here, and the second argument is the calculation that you want to perform. And that calculation, that sizing keyword that you passed in as the first argument, is available as size, essentially variable. Before I change it, I'll just show you that this no longer works. We don't have transition between open and close state of our widget. And if I just change this to two argument form and add a second argument as size, this will work immediately. As this second argument is a calculation, you can do something like size plus 50 pixels, and this will work exactly as you would expect. The size of this container will be determined by the content of this container, which is what the value auto does, plus 50 pixels. So why is the one argument form no longer working? As discussed in this GitHub issue, the one argument form was created in order to allow you to easily switch to new animation behavior that allows you to transition with intrinsic sizing keywords. But since then, we've gotten new CSS property, interpolate size, that you can use to opt into new animation behavior. Essentially, calc size is used if you want to do a calculation with intrinsic sizing keywords like auto in this example, but if you just want to simply enable opt-in to new animation behavior that allows you to work with intrinsic sizing keywords, then you will use interpolate size property. I'll comment out of the slime, so our animation no longer works. And now on this disclosure widget, I will set interpolate size property. And interpolate size property takes two different values. First, initial and default value is numeric only, which is the behavior that you're familiar with, where transitions happen only to numeric values, like 50 pixels, for example. In this case, CSS transitions don't happen to intrinsic sizes like the value auto, but the second value that's available for interpolate size is allow keywords. And allow keywords will allow you to use keywords for CSS transitions. So let's set it up. Once we do this, our animation will immediately work. As you can see, our transition to hide auto is working exactly as expected. And the actual recommendation is to set up interpolate size on the root property so you opt in the entire page to this new and proper transition behavior. I'll add this to my root element. And now because this interpolate size will be inherited by all the other elements on the page, our animation will work exactly as expected. I expect that this interpolate size property will end up in new CSS resets or in normalizes, where you will immediately want to switch your entire page to this new transition behavior so you don't have to think about will my transition to hide auto or any other intrinsic sizing keyword work. You will just immediately know that it will work. To recap, we have a new calc size function that allows you to do calculations with intrinsic sizing keywords. And if you want to opt in to new animation behavior without doing any kind of calculations, then you can use interpolate size property with allow keywords value, which will allow you to opt in to the new proper transition behavior. Both calc size and interpolate size are supported in stable Chrome 128, but the calc size is supported with the one argument value, which will not be supported in the next releases, and interpolate size property works as it should be working. Unfortunately, it is still not supported in Safari or Firefox, but hopefully the support will come soon. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Jambor. I will see and hear you in a different intrinsic sizing keyword, or rather in the next video, and specifically in this one.